Aquinas begins the Summa at the beginning. As an intellectual monk of sorts, he begins to ask the very first and primary question, the foundational question, which is, what are we doing? What kind of life, intellectual life, are we beginning to lead? And it's the life, the thought about God. So he asks in question one about the nature of sacra doctrina, which some translate sacred doctrine. More literally, it's a holy teaching. And one of the things that is elusive to students who first begin to read question one of the Summa Theologiae of St. Thomas is, what exactly is he doing here? And although he explains in this question what he's doing, if we don't know the broader contexts of Aquinas' thought, we can easily miss the why, the motivation for why he treats some things first, some things second, some things third, and then all the way to the end. And so a Thomas, in all of the articles, questions of the Summa, follows an order that is the order of wisdom, and the order particularly of scientia, science. Now today when we hear science, we think of Isaac Newton, Albert Einstein, Stephen Hawking. But Aquinas's understanding of science, or scientia, knowledge, comes from that great thinker, pagan thinker, Aristotle, and his work, in particular, Aristotle's work, The Posterior Analytics, where Aristotle explains what is necessary for, what is contained in, a certain scientific knowledge about reality, about any subject. And so because Aquinas wants to understand the truth about God, he has to follow, and he chooses to follow, this very structured mode of discourse and inquiry that is outlined and described in great detail by Aristotle in his book, The Posterior Analytics, and which Thomas himself in other places comments upon. He has a whole commentary on the Posterior Analytics. And so in the first question of the Summa, the structure proceeds according to three movements, which again are found in Aristotle. And the first question is, what on sit does this exist? Is this science necessary? That's the first part of question one. The second part is quid sit, which is, what is this? So we have a subject which is necessary. It is necessary to study God, okay? But what is this study of God exactly? The quid sit question. And he outlines that according to two subordinate movements. The first is, he tries to identify a generic definition, a generic understanding of what the science of God is. And then he moves to a specific understanding of what the knowledge of God is. And this follows the structure of all human knowledge, because human knowledge begins in generalities, and as we learn more and more, it becomes more specific, more exact, more discreet, more determinant. And then the final part is that he investigates is the mode, the manner by which one studies God. And so in question one, just to sum it up, Aquinas begins by asking, on sit, is this subject, this science, necessary? The second part is, what is this subject, this science, this study, exactly, generically, and then more specifically? And then the third and final part of question one is, what is the mode, what is the manner, what is the means by which we follow, arrive at this knowledge? And so this is the macro, the meta structure that governs all of the articles contained in question one of the Summa. It's centered on God, and it's ordered towards a more specific, particular, exact knowledge of God, and it terminates, finishes in, how exactly can a theologian pursue this knowledge? What mode, what means of arriving at this knowledge? What is the mode of of this knowledge. So, onset, is this necessary? Yes. What is this knowledge generally? What is this knowledge particularly? And then thirdly, what is the mode or manner of this knowledge?